keep shopping, and just tell me a little bit about how tough it is to make ends meet here. What is it?
Well, one thing I found out how to do real well is shop for bargains. That's something that you really learn how to do when you're working on a limited income. You have to learn how to budget your money, and food stamps are a precious commodity. They have to last for a whole month. But, something you just learn how to do. And that's good. It'll help me later on when I do finally get to work.
Bart,
and I make sure that, since I've been a single dad, I had to make sure that everything we eat got high nutrition and is good for you. Hey, cereal's the thing that about kills you. No such thing as cheap cereal. And you try to get the things that are nutritious for the kids and the right price too. See something on bargain. If that's 99 cents, stock up for the next time. Normally it's over $1.39, $1.49 when you buy it, so if you see it on sale, grab it. Stock up on it. Friends and buses. It's kind of hard to shop on a bus, so, but you do it if you have to. So you try to find somebody to trade favors with, like my friend Christian.
Gina, green line, please, Chief.
She helps you get back and forth, and you do things for her, and watch the kids, or whatever. On a day like today, where the weather is not too good, taking a bus is not the thing I wanted to do, so I'm really great. She's glad she had some time to help.
Food, how much food is this? Is this
going to
last you, or?
This is,
Bob, and Jim, red line, please, because
it's $30. This is the basis for maybe three meals. This is the basis. I still got to get some meat and stuff like that. But I try to just plan my meals as much as I can. You know, you can't spend all your food stamps in one shopping spree and
shop every month
because certain things you can't store. Milk, for instance. So you have to save enough for the end of the month. You just try your best to buy for a couple of weeks at a time. Maybe get staples for the month like sugar or flour or whatever.
Some of the stuff that other kids do.
No, my kids understand that for one thing, they were old enough when I was working and making pretty good money that they understand the difference in our lifestyle right now. But they also understand the fact that I'm going to college and it's going to get better. And the whole reason we're kind of tightening our belts right now is because we know that there's something at the end of the tunnel. And I'm doing this for them as well as myself. And I spoil them as much as I can with what I've got. I buy them treats. They just happen to like fruit and things like that, so I'm real lucky. Their uncle in Michigan owns a candy store, or a general store that's got a lot of candy, so they get stuff like that sent to them. So they don't go without that either, but I try to get them fruit and stuff. They've made it possible for me to get through the situation that I'm in right now without feeling bad about maybe, like you said, not getting them the things that all the other kids have. But the one thing I noticed since we've been short on money and the situation being what it is now, they tend to appreciate what they get more than they did when I had a lot of money. I'm pretty proud of them for coming to that realization. I can't get them, but they try their best to understand. They still want things sometimes that, you know, they're kids, they're normal kids, and they want things that they ask me for and I can't do. I can't buy for them, or I can't stop at McDonald's today, or I can't take them to Kmart and just buy them something for the heck of it. But they're, I don't know whether you'd call them used to it now, used to our situation, or whether they're just smart kids and they realize, well, you know, we're just not in a position to do that right now. And they'll ask a couple of times, and instead of harping on it, they say, okay, I understand. But I try my best to not make life any harder for them than I have to. If I can get them something a little extra, I do, as long as it's not going to put us in a bad position later on. That's why I say I look for things that are on sale. And when you see something on sale, you can afford to do something. But try to save the other money for birthdays and holidays. The kids, all kids need things on those days. You really can't cut it out on that. Can't go without a birthday.
Produce, thank you, please. Produce, thank you.
Thank you.
you doing?
Good.
Healthy meal and a better bargain out of buying it like this. You learn to do things like that, and that's what gets you to the market.
That's right, Italian-style roast beef or our regular roast beef, just $3.99 a pound today. We also have our salads on sale, potato salad or macaroni salad, your choice, 99 cents a pound. That's all right back here in your deli shop. We're located at the back of the store. And thanks again for shopping and saving with us today.
About treats to her, that's a treat. If I bring home, I don't need it, but she does.
Marilyn, red line, please, Marilyn.
Thank you.
I'm used to it now. When I first started doing it, I felt, I wouldn't call it a shame, but more or less uncomfortable. Like somebody was going to check my card to make sure I'm supposed to have these things. Make sure I'm doing everything legal. I got to the point where I show them my ID every time I got even a dollar food stamp. After a while, you just get used to it and you appreciate it, actually, after a while. And, I'll tell you what, you can get by with food. It's a lot easier than get by without any food. And, a lot of money, you know. If you don't have the money to spend for it, you're paying all your bills, it doesn't do anything for you for the food. Take your food stamps, no matter what bills you got to pay, you got to get food.
Hi, how are you doing?
Doing all right, how about you? Get over the illnesses from the winter, and this is.
Yep. Extra one.
69.80, right?
Oh wait, 69. Never mind. Thank you.